Hi everyone, this is Mathias Allen. Thanks for clicking on my video. I wanted to take you behind the scenes on one of my favorite clients, someone I'm truly, madly, deeply love with all my heart, my mom, Linda.
Hello.
I've had a lot of subscribers ask me, how is it that you do your mom's makeup so fantastically and glamorously? Because if you follow me on Instagram, which there is a link below, you can see a lot of times I take my mom out for special events, for weddings, and family functions. And tonight, I'm going to take her to see the Book of Mormon in Los Angeles. So I'm going to glamour up extra special, and I'm going to show you how I do that. So stay tuned. A link to part one of my beauty transformation with Linda is at the end of this video. I'll show you exactly how I created those stunning eyes. Cream foundations work great on dry skin because of their full coverage effect to hide any imperfections in the skin. However, the skin must be extremely hydrated before swiping on the cream foundation product, or it will drag on the dry patches and not look its best. I'm using a foundation brush first in order to place the product where I need it to go. The first color I chose was to create highlights on Linda's T-zone, cheekbones, and under her nose. This second color is for color matching to her actual skin tone. Linda's face is pinker than the rest of her neck and chest, which are extremely olive. My suggestion is to color match a client's neck, not her face, so that her foundation will match her overall body. Once the heavily pigmented cream foundation is applied, I like using my fingertips to warm the product into the skin and melt it into her pores and fine lines. I also like using a beauty blending type of sponge that is slightly damp to help smooth out the top layers of the skin prior to setting it all with powder. Finding the perfect concealer is key to any flawless face, and I am in love with this Senna concealer. It has a creamy texture, but without any oily residue. I'm applying it with a synthetic concealer brush under Linda's left eye only, just to show you the amazing difference. I love the satin finish it leaves when dry. Using my beauty blending sponge, I smooth out any edges where the concealer meets the previously placed foundation. The concealer is also used to add any additional coverage where needed on the skin, other than just under the eye. Setting the skin with a mattifying loose powder ensures a long-lasting finish, as opposed to mineral powders that are pretty on the skin, but don't help in making foundation last. As you can see, Linda has very sparse hair in her brow zone. Using a shadow or brow powder alone will work, but it will be harder to create a flawless looking brow because the powders just won't stick to the skin like this liquid brow gel from Makeup Forever. A pencil would work well, but most brow pencils aren't waterproof, and this product is. This technique of creating a brow structure where there really isn't much hair to follow is difficult unless you're a makeup artist like myself or you take the time to practice. For an even longer lasting brow, I go over the gel with a brow powder to fill in any holes and soften the look of the waterproof gel. Cream blushes are a great idea for mature skin because they add a dewy moistness to the skin that typically gets depleted after a certain age. I'm so in love with this shimmering highlight blush from Sigma because it adds the illusion of hydration back onto the top layers of the skin. See how it shines in the light? As if I just sprayed her skin with a moisturizing mist. Buffing one last layer of loose matte powder all over is my secret weapon against letting this face fade away as the night rolls on. I'm also diffusing the shimmer ever so slightly by buffing in this powder so it looks lit from within. I recommend using a matte powder to contour the hollows of the cheek with. using bronzers that have shimmer is a complete no-no. Shimmer should only fall high up on the apples of the cheeks, not deep in the contoured hollows. I'm adding a bit of contour around the hairline to shape Linda's forehead as well. Notice that I'm using the same brush I used to buff the last layer of loose powder. The brush picks up a softer amount of contour color because it still has a bit of loose translucent powder in it. The lips are reshaped easily by using a pigmented pencil like this one that is also waterproof and extremely fade resistant. I love the color choices and wearability of the entire Makeup Forever lip collection.
Voila! Now I have hair. Mathias, come fix my hair!
After placing my mom's magic hair on for the night, I style it by slightly backcombing it and making sure that her bangs are away from her gorgeous eyes. All right, everybody, that's it. That's my mom, Linda, and how I create glamour on women over 50. We're saying 50 this week, right? Women over 50?
Women over 50.
Women over 50. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Mom, how do you feel?
Fabulous. Just fabulous.
I love your new hair.
Oh, I know. Isn't it great?
Oh, my God. It's like the best hairdo ever.
I'm real happy.
Thanks for watching, and I hope you guys subscribe and stay tuned because there's going to be lots more Linda on my YouTube page because she's my favorite. Bye, Mom. Mwah! Hey you guys, don't go anywhere. Check out part one of my beauty transformation with Linda by clicking right here. I will show you exactly how I created those stunning eyes using waterproof cream shadow bases and eyeliner pencils, as well as how to make two full pairs of false eyelashes look so glamorous and fabulous.